Hello children, let us do our reading, that is with page number 2, chapter number 2, Day Dreams. Ready? Once there lived a couple who spent a lot of time in idle talk. One day, the husband said, "I have always wanted to keep cows. If by chance I get some extra money from somewhere, I am going to buy a few cows. But that means a lot of work. You have to feed the cows, walk them, bathe them, milk them. Cows need a lot of looking after. One cow would be enough. There is no need to buy more cows," said the wife. "But think of all the milk we will get if we buy more," said the husband. "That's true," the wife agreed. "There will be so much milk that we can even have plenty of dahi and butter and ghee. Wouldn't it be lovely? How lucky that I have all these earthen pots kept aside. I will use one of the pots for milk, one for dahi, one for butter. The ghee I will put in another jar, and I will use this remaining pot to send milk to my sister." "Send milk to your sister? Who said you could send milk to your sister? There will be plenty of milk if we have so many cows. Why shouldn't I send it to my sister? Because we are going to sell it in the market. That's why. I will decide what to do with all that milk, and not a drop of it goes to your sister, remember. I will see how you can stop me from sending a pot full of milk to my dear sister. I do all the hard work running after the cows, so naturally I will decide what happens to the milk. Just try stopping me," the wife exclaimed. "Is that so?" shouted the husband. "Watch this then." He began to lift and smash the earthen pots one by one. His wife began to scream. Gopal Bhand, who was passing by, heard all the commotion and rushed inside. When he heard what had happened, he picked up a stout stick that stood in a corner and began to swish it through the air and pound it on the floor. The husband and wife were both astounded to see his antics. "What are you doing?" they inquired. "Move aside," said Gopal Bhand. "I have to drive away your greedy cows. You have let them wander and now they have ruined my field of beans and cucumbers. Oh, my lovely field of beans and cucumbers." "But you don't have a field of beans and cucumbers," said the husband. As soon as he said that, Gopal Bhand stopped wielding the stick and looked at him with raised eyebrows. The husband and wife understood what he was trying to tell them. Can you tell what he wanted to say? Is it clear, children? So you also do the reading practice so that it would be easy. See, daydreams, couple, idyll, extra, feed, walk, bathe, enough, dahi, butter, ghee, earthen, market, exclaimed, lift, smash, scream, commotion, swish, ruined, wielding, eyebrows. Okay?